नमस्कार, आई एम हर्षवर्धन एंड यू ऑल आर वेलकम टू एस्क्वायर्स ऑनलाइन ट्रेनिंग चैनल। दिस इज एपिसोड 1 फॉर क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन टेक्नोलॉजीज। टुडे वी हैव अ स्पेशल गेस्ट विद अस, मिस्टर आर माधवन। ही इज अ प्रैक्टिसिंग फार्मर लाइक यू एंड सिंस लास्ट 30 इयर्स ही इज डूइंग हिज ओन फार्मिंग सक्सेसफुली। माधवन सर, आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम फार्मर्स। करेंटली आर फार्मर्स आर डूइंग द लैंड प्रिपरेशन and prepare the land for farming. You are also doing the land preparation. What is the difference which you are going to share, and what is the benefit for our farmers in land preparation technique?
Good question, Harsha. Thank you very much. Now, farmers are practicing only 10% of land preparation, but they are supposed to do 60% of their total value on land preparation alone. It is like building a house. A bird first builds the house and then lays the egg. That means the house plays a very vital role for the egg to be laid. Now, for us as a farmer, we have an egg seed. Now, that seed is put in the soil. Now, the soil has to be a house for plant. Are we giving importance to that effect? Which I say no. Unless we give that importance to the seed to nurture in the soil, then it will perform better. Say, for example, if the nest is not built properly, once the egg is laid on it, it will go down and crack, rot, or all sorts of negative things. Once, if the nest is very well built, then you put your egg there, then the hatching will take beautifully and the chicks will come productively. Similarly, we should put the seed. Before putting the seed, land preparation plays a very, very vital role. We are not giving that importance. In land preparation, we have many steps to follow. But we are just thinking land preparation means just plowing. Plowing is not land preparation. Land preparation includes, the first step is, we have to always remember optimum moisture for any mechanization to move. That we should keep it in mind. While keeping that in mind, the first operation is sizzle, or they call it deep plowing. It's called deep plowing. We are going to show a picture of how the sizzle look like. So this picture will tell you that it is a single shank to be attached to a tractor, and it draws around 3 feet in depth. Now, what are the advantages on this? It has got so much of advantages, you can't see them, but you can see the crop being performed very well. In my experience, as a farmer, my productivity jump happened. 40% of my productivity jump happened from this operation alone. And most of the farmers in India are not practicing this, which is very unfortunate. I'm going to talk about this particular tool importance and its use to you and to the community. First your pocket, then the community pocket. Now, what are the advantages that you're going to enjoy? Any little amount of rain is going to percolate deep down into the soil profile. Presently, what is happening? Due to the compaction of your soil, because continuously rain, tractor run, human going, so the soil has become very hard, very hard. It's like a hot pan. Now you have to crack that hot pan, allowing the rainwater to percolate down. Okay. The most important, rainwater being saved. You will be amazed on the rainwater being saved if I give you the numbers. And you may please refer the chart which is going to be shown in your window. What is the amount of water that you're going to save by doing this? Now, what is the benefit for the crop? Crop rooting system is the one which is not seen on the surface, and we also don't see it. That is the unfortunate. But plant has to eat, and mouth of a plant is root. And if you don't take care of the root, like us, if we don't have our mouth properly done, we cannot perform very well, because we can only eat through our mouth. And if you close the mouth or have some damages in the mouth, the whole body is get affected into this. Exactly. Now this root, once it gets affected due to the compaction issue, the proliferation does not take place. That is, number of roots are not opened because of the hard pan. By sizzling, you're cracking this hard pan, allowing the roots to proliferate freely. Once the roots are proliferated freely, you have the nutrients attached to the soil which get absorbed, and the plant performance jumps up. So now you have understood on this, the importance of sizzling. It saves water, root proliferation of crops takes up, which means you are saving water for your own farm, because most of us are all rain fed. I know, you know, how much of strain when the rains are expected and non-expected, but we waste a lot of water. Now this way we are saving the water for our own crop. By sizzling 3 feet in depth, you are allowing the root to go to that 3 feet and bring up the water. The soil has a characteristics called capillary action. Now all this, I don't want to put you with the too much of technical issues, but certain things that you have to understand what happens at the bottom level is a, you know, it's a little prerequisite to understand why should you use this tool. Once you have used it, I don't have to repeat that you have to do it. You will know the performance of crop is much better. The stress for water is minimized. You have saved a lot of rainwater. You might have seen it in the chart which was mentioning in the previous slide, how much of rainwater you have stored in your own field without doing anything, because this operation you're going to do for crop, but you're getting a bonus of saving the water also. Now the third important thing of sizzle, which I would like to mention, is surface runoff. Now with the soil compaction, any little rain, once it gets percolated to some level and then it runs away. When it runs away, it takes the top soil also, and the top soil are very important for the productivity of your crop. By sizzling, the top runaway is minimized. You should be happy now why we should sizzle. The next point we are going to talk about after the sizzle operation in the land preparation segment, the next one is you have to select which crop you're going to grow. Season. So these two play a vital role, which you are already familiar with. I don't have to repeat that, because as a farmer, you know these two things. Right. Now, once you know and decided on this, you have to test your soil. I completely agree, everybody is testing the soil. But are we doing it complete soil analysis? I'm going to repeat this, complete soil analysis for all micro macro nutrients. Micro macro nutrients are very, very important. Plants are like us. They want all the nutrients. Now, when I say that, soil test is equal to blood test. Now, soil test important, which we are not addressing it. It is like a blood test. Unless you take a proper blood test, how can a doctor give you a proper diagnostic and medicine to help you? Now, without knowing that, we cannot do. But taking a proper soil analysis, for which the vital part is collection of soil sample. For that, we have a chart which is showing a little tool, little gadget, which is called soil probe. we are going to give you a chart where how to collect soil is also shown in the chart. Once you collect the soil, you have to give it to a laboratory and demand for these elements, which is shown in the chart. Now, these elements tell you about your characteristics of your soil, which is physical and chemical. We need both the soil to understand. I'm going to remind you, a bird building a nest. See, it selects a particular twig, particular area, whether it is a rainproof, weatherproof, see, all that it takes into a precaution to build a house prior to putting the seed. We have to do that same thing if crop has to give us back the return. If the crop performance need to be doubled or tripled, these little simple technologies to be used. Once you collect the soil and you get the details of the required level of your nutrients, you have to address that nutrient and apply it in the soil. Now, we have to understand a little bit, and we are going to talk about on the complete segment about fertilizers. See, fertilizer is equal to plant food. Fertilizer is equal to plant food. Like us, we have food, and they have also to have some food, for which there are physical and chemical characteristics to be analyzed for the plant. The only difference is we can talk, but we have to talk on behalf of plant, because plant cannot talk. They can only show symptoms. So we have to look at the symptoms. That is the reason I said tools play a very vital role in collection of soil analysis. Now, you might ask, you know, as a farmer, why should I test the soil? Now, I am planting a seed. That particular plant needs nutrient to grow and perform well. How do I know what nutrient is available in the soil and how much do I add to my crop? How will you know? You can't just close your eye and say 100 kilos you put or 200 kilos you put. You can't do that. So you have to first know what is available and what is crop need. Now, when you know these two, how will you know? What is available is only the sources testing the soil. Once you test the soil, you will know what is available. And you know already what the crop is needed because you're going to select the crop, whether it can be jowar, whether it can be cotton, a capsicum, a cabbage, any crop, you know already, sugarcane or anything. First of all, you must know what is in your soil. It is like this. You take an example. You are inviting 1,000 people for your marriage. So you will go to the kitchen and see how much kilo of rice or of wheat is available there. You won't go to the shop first and then order the rice and wheat. You have to go to your stores and find out what is your stock. Then you know how many people are coming. Then you will come out with the result saying, oh, I have to buy another 50 kilos more or 50 kilo more. Or I don't have to buy, something is already there, so I don't have to add that more. Similarly, the soil will contain certain nutrients and certain nutrients deficient. Those deficient nutrients, you add it up for the next crop so that the crop will perform well. As I indicated, please remember, plant need 13 element of nutrients which they have to take from the soil only, excepting oxygen and the sunlight, but the rest is all through root system. From the soil they have to absorb. So anything has to be put in the soil where the mouth is. Take an example, if the mouth is here and if I go and take my food and then put under my arm, you think I'm going to grow? No way. So you have to put it in your mouth so that it gets into a system. Similarly, crop has to be fed where the root is, and the roots are buried underneath at certain areas. So you have to search for that. That is the reason we have to take the soil analysis. And that is the reason tool is important. How to collect? We have shown you the chart, how to collect it. Now in that format, you have to collect so that you get the representative of your soil. The lab will give you analysis what your soil contains. So now I think you are very clear why you should test the soil and that importance to send it to the laboratory in a proper scientific way. Not just pick up some soil and then throw it in the lab. Very simple thing. Garbage in, garbage out. If you don't take a soil to send it to laboratory, what you have taken, only the lab will give you the results of that soil. That means you have to take properly and give it to the laboratory. See, laboratory cannot make a, you know, magic and then give you some results. Laboratory can give you, any laboratory for that matter. It has to be taken properly in a scientific method as we have shown you in a list. How to handle the tool and how to collect it. Send it to the laboratory. Then you, what you are going to get is, what is your soil characteristics? That is not seen, you know, physically you see and then say, oh no, this soil has less of a phosphorus or a less of a potash. No way. Now I can't look at you and say, hey, whether you have a malaria or corona. I have to take a blood sample or I have to take a sputum test. You know, a test is needed to identify what is your problem. By physically looking at you, I can't tell you whether you have a malaria, cholera or a corona. You see, unless I take a sample of you, your various samples from you, either a blood sample or this or that, then I get the results. Once I know what is your problem, then the solutions are searched for and given it to you. I think I'm clear on this soil testing. Once we send it to the laboratory for analysis, in the meantime, we have to go with our land preparation. In the land preparation, I was talking about sizzle. Now, once we complete the sizzle and the soil testing results are brought in, say some are deficiency and some are in excess, based on that, we will be balancing them. See, anything needs to be balanced. It is like our food. We can't only eat rice, or we can't eat only wheat. If you continuously eat rice, you will end up in diabetes. Can you turn around and say rice is poison? No. Rice has to be balanced with other nutrients. Human being need protein, you know, energy to burn and talk and move. So energy is needed for that, protein to build your muscles, etc. Similarly, crop require all these nutrients. Now you're going to address this and balance the soil. That is, complete your platform, complete your nest for seeding, for your seeds to go into your the nest. Once the soil is given all the nutrients, you incorporate them using a tractor and an implement. Either you can use a 9-tine. We are going to show 9-tine. You're very familiar with the 9-tine cultivator. You can do that 9-tine or even a disc. I think you are sure you have seen many number of episodes showing the disc operation. You could use the disc. The idea behind is, what you have incorporated as a soil amendments are to be incorporated into the soil within about 9 to 11 inches. Now please remember why this 11 inches, 9 inches I'm talking about. I'm not very technically saying that. Always I said mouth. Now the plant has two set of roots. One is called anchor, other is called feeder. Just simple. One is to hold them from wind, from any stress, to be in the soil. The other one they move around and scavenging. You know what is scavenging is eating the nutrient from the soil. So this eating roots are within the oxygen zone. The more you go deeper, oxygen level drops down. That means their active feeding drops down as you go down. That's the reason I said 9 to 11 inches, the feed to be available for the root to absorb. Now you can ask a question saying, you said the roots can go deep down by sizzling. I mentioned it just a little earlier. Those roots are called tap roots, which means they can go, if you allow them to go, vertically down by 5 feet. By 5 feet. That means they can absorb water from that depth. You all know how important water is to the farmer. And that's the reason we talked about sizzle. Now I'm going to talk about the plant and land preparation. See, they are all interconnected between, you know, a plant is an interconnectual area. That's why I said 60% of it goes to the land preparation time alone, because that will determine your 50% of your productivity. If you miss anything in the land preparation, large chunk of your productivity is already lost, and that is irreparable. You all know the season plays a very vital role in farming. So you cannot even miss a day. So you can't say, no, I'll go back and then redo the whole thing. It's not possible in farming, because we have to work along with the nature. So the pattern has to be set in. We cannot afford to lose time. So when we are planning, we have to give importance. 50% of your productivity, land preparation, which means you have to work 60% of your time in entire farming operation is on the land preparation. Now you have done this. You have applied the soil inputs, incorporated them. It's always better, instead of broadcasting the seeds on a flatbed, it's preferable. I'm going to talk about the importance of this in irrigation later part of my episode. What is the important role that it gives? See, I said this land preparation has a connectivity for the entire duration. I talked about sizzle, then I have to talk about your soil preparation. That is soil testing. Now I'm going to say your method of planting. Now I'm going to shift it to the irrigation. Do you see? They are all interconnected. So this land preparation takes away so much of your other problems solved within this area. And we are ignoring this. Unfortunately, I'm very sad that our farmers ignore this vital area and then put all their effort in the other areas, which is not going to give them any results. Unfortunately, we have to build a nest properly. Once you lay the egg, you cannot alter the house. I'm sure you will agree with that. And see, after all, a bird is so much of cleverer. It beautifully lays egg only on a well-built nest. Not simply, you know, just throw away egg there. Not at all. And then turn around and then say, you worship the egg, put some kumkum to the head. All that is, you know, that won't work. You see, you have to build a nice, beautiful nest, put the egg, then you're sure to get a good hatchling. There's no doubt at all. Once you've done your land preparations, put your soil amendments, you form ridge and furrow. Ridge and furrow, we are going to show a tool for that. And the tool is, you know, visible there. That tool will tell you the ridge and furrow can be altered. That tool, you know, we will talk about that tool. Experts will give you how to change the tools and all those things in an episode. We will follow that, follow it up, so you will understand the importance of how to operate that tool. Special experts will do that. The advantages, I'll talk about it. Why should I do that and why not on a flatbed? In ridge and furrow, the advantages, I can weed mechanically. The weed is the biggest menace in farming. You will all completely agree with me. Managing weeds is a complete menace. It kills our economy. And that's the reason we remain on a low caliber in economical values, because it competes with the crop. And I won't go in depth because you know what wheat can kill you. It takes away nutrients. It takes away your water. So these two are major killers for our crop. But on a flatbed, it is very difficult to weed mechanically. You cannot weed it mechanically. The second one. Now, I would like to spray, you know, do some pest operation. Or I would like to run my combiner for my harvest at the end. You see, I'm shifting from land preparation to harvest, already jumping there. So you are planning here for the harvest. And if you don't do that now, in harvest, you will have a problem. You cannot do anything. There, you know, you'll have a lot of wastage. The machine getting in there would be a difficult issue. So you have to do manually. And you know all those, you know, the dramas which we have to go through by manually. It's not about replacing manpower. See, I'm not saying that only machines to do, but how to enhance. Say, if I can carry 100 kilos, can I use a tool to carry 500 kilos? So that means I still have to work, but in a more efficient way. So the efficiency comes in with the tool. And that's the reason we are going to use this Ridge and Furrow for these operations, much more than that which I'm going to talk about in the irrigation segment and in harvesting segment. Now, the another thing on this Ridge and Furrow where I would like to bring it now itself is population. In your productivity, plant population per acre plays very, very important role in your productivity segment. That means, if I can say, for example, I'll take an example of corn. A corn picture is shown to you where it is coming out with the cob. Now, plant wants equal amount of sun energy. That means, you are 1 acre of land, you have to distribute it to those crops, taking sufficient space so that they can work using the sun. The solar plays a vital role. You all know we worship, as a farmer, we worship on our harvest day to sun god, which means what? Sun plays a vital role. It means we have to distribute the sun to all the plants properly. That you can only accomplish through Ridge and Furrows. That means population can be uniformly planned. Once you plan the population uniformly, depending on your crop, you have to select what type of a crop and there is a pattern for it. Now, we have a tractor to use it. One tractor we should be able to manipulate for all our operations. Whether it is a sizzle, whether it is a pest management, Ridge and Furrow, etc. Harvest. Even harvest, we can hire the tractor. See, after all, we can hire a combiner. But we have to, our land has to be ready, right? So that the tractor can get in there. What is the use of a tractor having a machine and then you can't, you know, allow the tractor to get in there because of your land, poor land preparation. Now, the Ridge and Furrow advantages of this, the most important one, we get rains all of a sudden. In a flatbed, water stagnates. I'll go back a little. You have not sizzled the land, so the stagnation occurs. Stagnation means the roots which have to eat and perform are now inundated, choked. Say, for example, I'm thirsty, right? I have to give a water in a glass, I have to drink it from a glass. Not because I'm thirsty, you open up a 5 horsepower our agriculture pump and then throw it in my mouth. And then say, now drink. That's what we are doing now. And that's what the rains do it. And we can't stop rains. We need rains. But how to manage the rain to our requirements and our ability to use it efficiently is the one which we are using all these tools. In a flatbed, which most of the farmers across India, whenever I travel, whether it is in Madhya Pradesh, growing soybean, in Maharashtra, farmers growing sugarcane, or even you go down south in Karnataka, people growing vegetables, mostly on a flatbed or not properly done on a bed, so the population is low. Whenever the rain comes, due to this inundation, plant sleeps. It is not performing. So the crop cycle itself is 100 days and you make the crop to sleep for 20 days. how will you expect any return out of this crop? So that means land preparation in farming region, furrows, these are all the advantages. We will discuss on this more in the irrigation episode, because that is interrelated with that episode also. So you can watch during the next couple of episodes, you will get irrigation also. And then irrigation, we will talk what important this region furrow is done. Once region furrow is done now, right, okay, we are done with it. Now, the fertility of most of the Indian soil, most of the Indian soil's fertility, that is nutrient availability, is very low. We want this crop to get those nutrients at their mouth. As I told you, root or the mouth. So I have to give them at the root. How do I give? After this ridge and furrow, you go with, there is a tool which is shown on the screen. It's called placement of fertilizers. Now, this placement of fertilizer means I am applying fertilizer in band. You see, they are applied in band below the soil surface at a different depth. Now, these depths are also important. As I again keep on repeating on that, the roots proliferate. And wherever they are moving, if they see the nutrients, they jump up and then they absorb. And you are placing exactly on the root band at a various depth. Now, this tool is doing that job. We will discuss all these tools in a separate episode. Tools will be explained to you separately. I'm going to talk about here on only on crop production. That means you have to use this tool, that's all. But how use it, how to put it, how to go it, we will make a separate one small shot with these implements. And the technical experts will give you the guidelines of how to connect the tractor and all that. That is done for you easily. Our technical team will also talk to you on this in a little more detailed in a separate episode. The importance of fertilizer placement tool, I will have a word. I was mentioning 13 nutrients. Out of these 13 nutrients, you have to understand there are two segments. One is called mobile and immobile. Let me not confuse it. Mobile means they can go down to the soil root area. There are some material like potash, they are immobile. That means if you apply on the surface, on the top soil surface, where is the root? Under the soil. And where you have applied the food? On the surface. Now, how does the crop get it? The performance, like I said, my mouth is here, but you are trying to feed me under my arm. So I'm not going to grow. If I have to grow, you have to feed into the mouth. But you are not ignoring the mouth and feeding it somewhere else and wondering why my crop is not performing. Now, this fertilizer placement tool exactly puts into the mouth before even seeding. See, you don't even seed. This is called land preparation. That's why I said 60% is given to this area. Now, this feed, which are immobile, is given in band. This tool is doing that job. Because of the immobility, the plant has to get it. Take an example of urea. You are all very familiar with urea. If you apply urea, it will easily go down. But if you apply phosphorus or if you apply potash, it is not. It will remain in the soil itself. It won't be available for that crop. So that means that 100 days, it will be remain on the surface. If there is going to be any excess rain, I was indicating runoff will take away this nutrient also and wash down to the rivers or ponds. That is the reason all our ponds are very lush green. You might have noticed our fields are yellow. The ponds are very green because all these nutrients have been washed with the rain. Why? Soil compaction. We discussed that earlier. So, sizzle can prevent this nutrient loss also. Now, once you have placed the fertilizer in bands and you are ready with your seeding. I hope this episode has given you sufficient knowledge. As you have a question hour also, you have a sufficient knowledge where the importance, you know, don't get into the technical areas and then confuse yourself. You have the ready tools with you, and we are going to guide you on how to use these tools, how to connect to your tractor and all that separate. Somebody will going to do that. Once you have done it, this land preparation is done and you are ready with your seed or a transplant. Whether you are doing transplanting or whether you are seeding, this is done. Thank you.
Much, sir, for giving wonderful, unique and productive information on the land preparation to all our farmers. Hope our farmers will go through this episode and take full benefit out of it. Meanwhile, our farmers will raise a lot of questions and queries over this episode. So we will create a question and answer session video specially for them. Farmers, please do raise your comments in the comment box with your questions and queries, so that we would try to prepare the answers for all your questions. And coming Friday, we will publish a special episode called Q&A for this particular episode. And next main episode, we are coming up with fertilizer, that is nutrition for plants. How to identify what nutrition should be available for which plants, detailing on that will be available on episode number 2. So with this, I'm going to end the episode 1. Thank you very much.